children, welcome back to the online classes. So in previous sessions we have completed our first chapter, real numbers. Today we are going to start our second chapter, polynomials and factorization. So before entering into the content, let us see the learning outcomes. First we are going to discuss introduction of polynomials. Next, polynomials in one variable, degree of a polynomial, zeros of a polynomial, next dividing a polynomial using remainder theorem, factorizing a polynomial using factor theorem, and last one is algebraic identities. So children, in previous classes we have studied about algebraic expression. Such expression involves the variables like x, y and z. Today in this chapter we are going to discuss about a polynomial. Children, exactly what is the meaning of a term polynomial? So if you split a polynomial into two parts, like poly and nomial. Poly means many and nomial means terms. So the basic meaning of polynomial is many terms. A collection of many terms is called as a polynomial. So let us now see the definition of a polynomial. Polynomial is an expression consists of variables and real numbers that involves the operations of addition, subtraction and multiplication and have a non-negative integer exponents. So what are polynomials, sir? Polynomials are part of algebraic expression that includes variables and real numbers. Here the variables that involves only the operations of addition, subtraction and multiplication. Divisions and square roots cannot be involved in the variables. This is only the distinguished feature that separates them from algebraic expression. The divisions and square roots that cannot be involved in the variables of the polynomial and have a non-negative integer exponents. Here non-negative integer exponents means what? The exponent should not be a negative value, or we can say it as whole numbers. It should have a whole numbers. Now let us consider an example, y square plus 2y minus 3. Here y square is first term, 2y is second term and minus 3 is a third term. So it is an algebraic expression and it is also a polynomial. The exponent of first term is what here? 2. Exponent of second term is 1 and the third term is constant, isn't it? So the constant, as a constant contains no variable, it can be written as product of y to the power of 0. So the exponent of constant will be what here? 0. So what you observe here, children, the exponents are 2, 1 and 0. So which are whole numbers? That is non-negative integer exponents. So an important feature of polynomial is the exponents can be only 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That is, exponents have to be a whole number. So the variables can have exponents from a set of whole numbers and no negative exponents or fraction is involved. So as all the exponents are whole numbers, this is a polynomial. Now let us move on to the few examples which are polynomials and which are not polynomials. So examples of polynomials: 4x square plus 5x minus 2 and root 3x square plus 5y and 7x. 7 here, 7 is a constant and the exponent is of constant is 0. And next one is minus 5xy square. What do you observe here? All the variables have a non-negative integer exponents or a whole numbers. Now let us move on to the examples of non-polynomials. First example is 3xy to the power of minus 2. Here this is not a polynomial. Why? Because it has a negative power minus 2. And second one, 2 by x plus 2. It is also not a polynomial because already we have discussed divisions are not allowed. Next one, root x can be written as x to the power of 1 by 2. So this is also not a polynomial because 1 by 2 is not a set of whole numbers. Next, we are going to learn polynomial in one variable. Polynomial in one variable is an algebraic expression where there is only one variable present. Now let us consider an example, 3x square plus 2x minus 5. In this expression, x is only the variable present. Next example, 4y square plus y plus 9. So in this expression, y is only one variable present. Now let us see what is not a polynomial with one variable. Let us consider an example, 5x square plus 3y plus 9. In this expression, what do you observe? X and y are the two variables present. So this is not a polynomial with one variable. Now let us learn next topic, degree of a polynomial. Degree of a polynomial is the highest power of the variable in the given polynomial. Means the terms with highest power in a polynomial decides the degree of a polynomial. Let us consider an example, 3x square plus 2x plus 5. 3x square is the first term, 7x is the second term, and 5 is the third term. So the exponent of first term is 2, and the exponent of second term is 1, and the exponent of constant 5 is 0. So what you observe in this polynomial, children, as a term 3x square has a highest power, so the degree of this polynomial is 2. Now suppose if the terms has many variables, then what we have to do? We have to add all the exponents of all the variables multiplied in the terms to get the highest power of the polynomial. In the first term, let us consider one example, 3x square y cube plus 4xy minus 7. So in the first term, the exponent of x is 2 and the exponent of y is 3. So the sum of the exponents is 2 plus 3, which is equal to 5. Next, in the second term, 4xy, each of them have exponents equal to 1. So the sum of the exponents is 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2. And the exponent of third term is 0. As constant, exponent will be 0. Here, what do you observe? As a term, 3x square y cube has a highest power, so the degree of polynomial is equal to 5. You have seen a polynomials of degree 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So can we write down a polynomial in one variable of degree n for any natural numbers n? So a polynomial in one variable x of degree n is an expression of the form an x to the power of n plus a n minus 1 x to the power of n minus 1 plus a n minus 2 x to the power of n minus 2 plus so on a 1 x to the power of 1 plus a 0. This is called as a general form of a polynomial in one variable and degree n. That is, any degree n. N could be any whole number like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Now where a n, a x to the power of n, a n minus 1, x to the power of n minus 1 and plus so on a 0. These we call them as the terms of the polynomial. Next, a n minus 1, a n minus 2 plus so on a 0 are the coefficients of the variables x to the power of n, x to the power of n minus 1, x to the power of n minus 2 and so on. And n is called as a degree of a polynomial if an is not equal to 0. Now let us consider an example of a polynomial x cube minus 2x square plus 3x plus 11. So what is the degree of this polynomial? As the highest power is 3, so degree of this polynomial is 3. As degree of polynomial is 3, let us take n value as 3. Now let us substitute n is equal to 3 in the general form. If you substitute this n value in the general form, you will be getting a 3 x to the power of 3 plus a 3 minus 1 x to the power of 3 minus 1 plus a 3 minus 2 x to the power of 3 minus 2 plus a 3 minus 3 x to the power of 3 minus 3. Now let us simplify this. You will be getting a3 x cube plus 3 minus 1 is 2, a2 x to the power of 2, 3 minus 2 is 1, a1 x to the power of 1 plus 3 minus 3 is 0, a0 x to the power of 0. Now a3, a2, a1 and a0 are the constants and x cube, x square and x1 are the variables. Now let us take a polynomial x cube minus 2x square plus 3x plus 11. Now comparing this polynomial with a general form, when we compare the coefficient of x cube with the general form of x cube, then a3 value will be equal to 1. X square with x square, then a2 value will be equal to minus 2. X with the x, then a1 value will be equal to 3 and constant will be equal to 11. So in this way we can derive the general form of the polynomial of any degree. Suppose if all the coefficients are 0, that is an is equal to an minus 1 is equal to and so on, a2 is equal to a1 is equal to a0 is equal to 0, then what we will get, children? This entire thing will become 0, isn't it? So 0 into x to the power of n plus 0 into x to the power of n minus 1 plus 0 into x to the power of n minus 2 plus so on plus 0. So 0 is multiplied to anything is 0. So this will be equal to 0. Since all the coefficients are 0, we get a 0 polynomial. So what is the degree of the 0 polynomial? It is not defined. Why? As we can't write it as a product of a variable raised to any power. So, degree of the 0 polynomial is not defined. Children, today we have discussed about polynomials, coefficient of polynomials, degree of polynomials and general form of polynomials of degree n and 0 polynomials. I hope so you have understood today's content. Thank you and have a nice day.